Thank you for introducing me. It is a great honor to be able to speak to you today. Before I start, I'd like to thank Professor Gans and Fasian for organizing this workshop and inviting me. Today, I'd like to talk about the visual modeling for drones that prevents the appearance of unmonitored areas in between their field of views. The drones are being used in many application fields, including environmental modeling and surveillance, because of the high mobility and ease of deployment and capability of mounting various sensors. This movie also shows those favorable characteristics are utilized in a visual tracking scenario where a drone is capturing one vehicle. On the other hand, if we want to monitor a wider area, utilizing multiple drones for monitoring is one of the reasonable solutions to obtain high resolution image from the environment. In this scenario, the question is how to cooperatively control multiple drones to capture the target without overlooking it. In this presentation, we introduce a control method that prevents the appearance of unmonitored area in between their field of views. And then we demonstrate that the proposed method makes a robot behave as a team and prevent the misdetection of the target that may arise in between their field of views. So one of the control methods that achieves environmental modeling with mobile sensors is coverage control. The coverage control deploys mobile sensors to optimally collect the data with distributed computation among robots. In the left movie, the importance of a point is set to uniform. So the robot equally divides the environment into subregions being charged by each of them. Furthermore, we can specify that a part of the environment is especially worth monitoring, as you can see in the right movie. Here, the human operator commands which area should be monitored by the robot, and you can confirm that the robots are gathering around the red area, which is specified by the human operator. This coverage control is also applicable to drone networks. And in the following few slides, I would like to explain the coverage control that is also utilized in a proposed method. First, we denote the robot position as PI and assume its dynamics is modeled as a self-model as a single integrator. The environment to be monitored is defined as capital Q. The importance of each point in the environment is expressed with a density function phi, which takes a higher value at an important area. This density function corresponds with the one human specified in the previous slide. Then, the coverage performance of the robots is evaluated with this cost function j. This cost function considers how well the important area is monitored with a sensor mounted on the robots. In this formulation, if the point is close to the robot, the point is regarded to be monitored with high resolution. Since we want to maximize this coverage performance, the control input is based on the gradient of this cost function, which can be calculated in distributed manner. This movie shows this control input drives the robot to cover this environment while gathering the important area. Here, the robot's position is depicted with red dots. In the next slide, we will take a closer look to this control input. This control input is described as follows. Here, M and C is derived from the Voronoi partition. The Voronoi partition divides an environment into subregions close to each of the robots. For example, from the point in the green region, the robot one is the closest robot from the point. This is the formal expression of the Voronoi partition, where the Euclidean distance is used as a distance metric. Then, MI is the area, and CI is the centroid of Voronoi region. With this control input, each robot converges to a centroid or the vulnerable region, as you can see in this figure. This coverage control can be applied to the drone networks, but of course, there are several differences. In the next slide, we will explain the differences while introducing the scenario and challenges we will discuss in this talk. We consider the scenario where a team of drones equipped with downward-facing camera monitor the environment. Same with the previous slide, we denote the robot position as PI. The control variables is the robot position PI and the camera's focal length level. This corresponds with the zoom level of cameras. One of the most significant differences from the previous slide is that the camera mounted on the drone only has a limited sensing field, as you can see in this figure. We denote the robot eyes field of view as FI and model it as a circular region. And sometimes we denote field of view as FOV in the slide. In case a drone's field of view is limited, the drones cannot monitor every ground point with high resolution as you can see in this movie. Therefore, if you utilize the standard coverage control only, the unmonitored area appears, as you can see in this movie. Although we cannot cover the full area as the number of drones is limited, we can prevent the appearance of the unmonitored area in the important regions. With this motivation, we paid attention to the unmonitored area that in between the robot team, which is shown here, because that tends to be the variable region, considering that the agents converge to the important region. By preventing coverage faults, we aim to decrease the misdetection of the target that may appear small from the sky, such as humans or vehicles. And this monitoring strategy can improve the performance of monitoring or situation awareness. Hereafter, we introduce a control method that prevents the appearance of unmonitored areas in between the drone network that can be integrated to the coverage control. To prevent the appearance of coverage faults in between a drone network, we paid attention to the power diagram. The power diagram is known as the generalization of the standard vulnerable partition to the robot network, which has a heterogeneous sensing regions. Let me explain with this figure. If we use the standard vulnerable partition, it separates the environment by the bisector, regardless of the sensing regions of these robots. In contrast, the power diagram allocates a broader region to the sensor having a large sensing field, as you can see in this animation. If the two robots' sensing field has overlap, this line passes these two intersection points of field of views. The forward expression of the power diagram is written here, where the distance dp is used instead of the Euclidean distance. Now, we discuss the relationship with the power diagram and the prevention of coverage faults in between a drone network. In this figure, the field of view of the drones is depicted with green circles, and the partition of power diagram is shown in black lines, and the red line shows the network of this network, which preserves the edges of the power diagram only between those neighbors whose field of view has overlap. We got inspiration from this figure that containing the blue vulnerable vertices is one of the critical conditions to prevent the coverage fault in between a drone network. Furthermore, because this vulnerable vertices is generated by the three drones, which is determined by this triangular subgraph, we can divide the problem into each triangular subgraph. Therefore, we will first consider how these vulnerable devices relate to the prevention of coverage holes in the case of three agents. After that explanation, we will extend the result to the network composed of many drones. The deployment of three drones can be roughly divided into three cases. And for the left configuration is the only case having a coverage hole. By drawing a part diagram vertex via JK, we can confirm that containing the vertex via JK in its field of view is the robot can eliminate the coverage hole, as you can see in this panel. Is this condition alone enough? Unfortunately, no. This is too conservative because a hole may not appear even if V is outside of these field of views. To resolve this conservativeness, we also need to check whether this vertex is surrounded by three drones by checking this triangle IJK. More concretely, we prove that the necessary and sufficient condition not to make a hole in between a torio is described by this logically combined set. These two movies visualize the meaning of the above conditions. In the left movie, the red drone moves toward upward direction while satisfying this red condition only. Since the vertex does not allow to leave the field of view, the red drone's movement is overly restricted. In contrast, the right movie includes both conditions, and two conservative behavior shown in the left movie is resolved, and the coverage hole is also prevented. So let me explain the explicit form of this set in the next slide. First, the condition that confines V inside of FI field of view is described as this function. This function HIF simply implies that V, distance between V and center, should be smaller than radius. Second, we can confirm that whether V is outside of triangle IJK by checking these inequalities, which composed by three inequalities combined by logical disjunctions. Here, HIJ takes a positive value when V and triangle IJK exist in the different half plane created by this line IJ. By conducting the same evaluation for each edge, we can check whether VIJK is outside of this triangle. Since all these four inequalities are combined by logical disjunctions, we can prevent the appearance of coverage holes by satisfying only one of them. As a result, the condition to be satisfied is described by this condition utilizing the max operator. The next question is how to incorporate this constraint into the control law that addresses environmental modeling. For this goal, we utilize the control barrier function mesh. The control barrier function is known as a powerful tool to confine the state of the system into the admissible set C. Let us assume that the system dynamics is given and the admissible set is defined with the function H. Then the function H is called the control barrier function if there exists a control input U that satisfies this constraint. This constraint is composed of the time derivative of H and the extended class kappa function. Let me explain the meaning of these inequalities with this figure. If H takes a large positive value, this constraint allows H dot to take a negative value. It means if H has a large margin, H may decay, as you can see in this figure. In contrast, when H is approaching to zero, This constraint makes edge dot to take a positive value. In other words, if edge is close to the boundary, edge must increase, as you can see in this figure. This control variable function is integrated to the control law with the quadratic programming. The control input is the output is optimization problem, where the nominal control input is modified minimally invasive way so that this CBF-based constraint is satisfied. Let's consider how to apply this CBF-based approach to a environmental monitoring method. In our case, the condition preventing coverage hole is described as a four function combined by the max operator. Therefore, there exists a non-smooth point where the function taking the maximum value switches, as you can see in this figure. At this non-smooth point, the gradient utilized in the CBF condition becomes a set. To incorporate the functions that is composing this gradient set, we introduce this index set proposed in this paper. This index set basically means that the functions close to the maximum value should be also integrated to the CBFs. Here, the nominal control input is calculated based on the coverage control. If we tolerate some conservativeness, we can distribute this QP-based controller to each robot, and by using the symmetric nature of the proposed control variable function. So far now, we consider how to prevent a coverage hole in between a toroid. Finally, we extend the discussion into the scenario with a network having many drones. As we observed in the part diagram, we can separate the team of the drones into triangular subgraph, as you can see in this figure. Then, quadcopter I only needs to satisfy the CBF condition determined by this triangular subgraph. But we need to consider graph changes that cause the addition or subtraction of the CBF condition. If this added CBF does not become a negative in the moment of graph changes, this is not a problem. In other words, if the graph change does not cause a sudden appearance of a hole, we don't need to worry about it. Although most of the graph changes do not cause a hole, some types of graph change could generate a hole, and it makes edge negative. To resolve this problem, we leverage another favorable characteristic of the CBF. As we introduced in the previous slide, the CBF constraint is described as this inequalities, and this implies that if edge takes a negative value, edge dot must be a positive. So it means that if edge breaks the constraint, this CBF can drive edge back to the positive value, as you can see in this figure. Therefore, in our case, even if the graph change could cause a hole, the CBF can eliminate it. So let's see the simulation result that also shows this behavior. Here, we compare the proposed method with the one only using coverage control. We also plot the value of CBF and coverage performance. If we employ the coverage control only, the unmonitored area appears, as you can see here, and that coverage hole may result in a larger unmonitored area. In contrast, the proposed method prevents the appearance of holes while allowing the graph changes. Here, the hole appears because of the graph change, but because of the favorable characteristic of CBF, we can eliminate it. Also, from the left panel, you can confirm the the coverage performance reaches the same level of the one using only coverage control. Let's see the experiment result too. In this experiment, we set four quadcopters, and the important area is set to the right upper corner in the environment. As you can see from the top view, all four drones moved to the important area while preventing the appearance of coverage holes. And we can also confirm that the value of CBF keeps in the positive value. In the second experiment, we consider the object search scenario where the drone network utilizes the visual feedback from the mounted camera. In order to detect the target to be monitored, the drone network needs to patrol the environment. To realize this patrolling behavior, we utilize a time decay density function. This density function has a lower importance as the area recently visited and have large importance that has not been monitored yet. Once we detect the target, we fix the density function, which has a peak at the detected target. As a constraint, we impose the CBF, which prevents the coverage hole, as similar with the previous experiment. And in addition to this, we set flight time limit, which is decided with the battery limit. Namely, if the battery is depleted soon, each drone returns to the charging station. This is the experimental setting where we prepare the virtual charging stations in the experimental field. The vehicle to be detected is placed in the environment where the drone network starts to find it by the visual feedback from the mounted camera. The position and velocity of each drone is tracked by the motion capture system, and the drones can communicate with the experimental PC via Wi-Fi, and the onboard image is also sent to the PC, and the object detection is conducted by the TensorFlow. Based on this data, Matter calculates the control input and send it to the drone networks. Here is a movie of the experiment. The panel on the right shows the visual data captured from each drone. First, three drones gathered and form a team for preventing a coverage hole. The value of CBF is confirmed in the left upper corner, and we can confirm that it keeps in the positive value. Then the drone network starts patrolling via time dependent function, and once it detects the target, it stays above it. And if the battery is depleted soon, each drone returns to the virtual charging station, as you can see in this movie. Finally, I would like to conclude my presentation. In this presentation, we propose a visual monitoring technique that prevents the appearance of unmonitored area in between the field of views. And as a demonstration, we conducted the object search scenario. And in that experiment, we use the visual feedback to detect the target from the environment. As the future works, we are planning to evaluate the proposed method in a virtual environment, because conducting the real-world experiment in cities is really difficult. But at the same time, we would like to conduct an experiment in an outdoor experimental field and check how our proposed method works in the real-world scenario. So thank you for listening. I will be happy to take questions.
Well, thank you, Riku. That was interesting. We have 5 minutes for questions specifically about this paper, so I'll go ahead and open up the floor. Okay, well, I have a question. So, does somebody else have one?
So the question I see is the extension, the elliptic field of view is right. So
I think it looked like you have an assumption that the camera is facing straight down so that you get a circular projection. And I guess you're suggesting that if the camera's at an angle, like it's on a gimbal, then the, yeah, okay.
Yeah, we are assuming that each quadcopter equipped with gimbal, but we are also considering how to extend to this research, which have the elliptic field of view. But there are several difficulties and we are still working on it. For example, in order to prevent the coverage faults, we are heavily relying on the power diagrams written here. And this power diagram has several favorable characteristics. And the one with a significant one is that it returns a convex cell, like you can see here. But if we consider more complicated volumetric diagram that can deal with the shape of the field of view mentioned or elliptic field of view, the Voronoi cell becomes too very complicated one, as you can see in this figure. And at this moment, I'm not sure whether we can construct the constraint preventing the coverage hole from this kind of Voronoi diagram. I hope this answers your question.
Yeah, his second question I had also agreed upon, that you have a square image or rectangular image, and so the ellipsoid is actually even a bit conservative, overly conservative, right? Because you're eliminating a little bit of your field of view from your calculations, so.
Yes, I agree with that. To eliminate the conservativeness, we want to start from the elliptic field of view. And if the robot pose, I mean, if the elliptic orientation is same with all drones, maybe we can extend that. But still, we are considering.
Since you're using these control barrier functions, I'm a little frustrated because it's escaping me right now, but I remember reading some work where people, I think, were using like mixed integer programming approach to barrier functions, and they could get by with having then just straight lines to define their barriers instead of, you know, quadratics or ellipsoids and stuff. And since if you were trying to do something with an image barrier that was now composed of straight lines, that would be an approach. I really have to kind of remember what it is. It's sort of vaguely recalled in my mind, but they have been doing something to keep away from walls and such. And they were able to, I think, like I said, used a mixed integer programming for their barrier functions. And it was quite quick and accurate.
Thank you for your valuable advice. I'd like to check that paper. Same with we are using now a logically combined CBF, and I think we can manage.
Way off on that, so take whatever I say with a grain of salt, but